What is the soil food web? To understand the soil food web, let's start with the term food web. We all know about the food chain, the animal kingdom on top of which are us humans, right? Well, if we look a little closer, we can see that some members of the food chain don't just eat one thing. That goes for humans too. So the reality is more like a web than a chain. This is the food web. There happens to be a food web in the soil too. This is the living part of the soil made up of insects, earthworms, and much smaller microscopic creatures such as fungi and bacteria. Dr. Elaine Ingham has pioneered research into the microorganisms in the soil over the last four decades, and has worked with a team of research scientists to understand how they interact with each other and with plants. The soil food web can be thought of as the soil biome. Just as humans have a gut biome, responsible for digesting our foods, so too the soil has a biome, which breaks down organic matter and releases nutrients in plant-available form. This is how nature has been feeding plants for billions of years. The major groups that make up the soil food web are bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and nematodes. When in balance, these different groups interact with each other and with plants to create abundant ecosystems such as the great forests of the world. Have you ever wondered how forests can be the most productive ecosystems in the world without the need for any fertilizers or pesticides? The answer lies in soil biology. With a healthy biome, the soil can provide plants with all the nutrients they need. And with a number of other benefits, such as protection from pests and diseases, protection from drought and from flooding, the soil food web is, essentially, nature's operating system. Unfortunately, we humans have disturbed the soil food web in almost all of the soils that we manage, causing it to become unbalanced. As a result, the plants we grow struggle. Plowing is the major cause of the problem, as it destroys the larger microorganisms, such as fungi and protozoa, leaving the soil food web out of balance. This results in a system breakdown. Nutrients are no longer made available to plants, and protection from diseases is compromised. Before the Industrial Revolution, humans would plow using oxen or a bull, which provided around 3 or 4 horsepower. Modern tractors can yield 400 horsepower or more. So far more damage is done to the soil biome by modern machinery. The use of chemicals has compounded the problem. The good news is that we can restore the soil food web to most soils within just a few months. This results in a number of benefits, both for farmers and for the environment. With a balanced soil food web in place, farmers need not use fertilizers at all. They don't need to use pesticides either, as nature's operating system protects plants from attack. Herbicides, used to kill weeds, are not required either, as weeds only thrive in conditions where the food web is out of balance. Restoring the soil food web means farmers save money on chemical inputs across the board. It also means that their yields increase dramatically. In some cases, farmers working with Dr. Elaine Ingham have seen yields increase by over 200%. This is because the soil food web provides plants access to a constant flow of nutrients from soil organic matter, and from the soil particles themselves. That's right, sand particles contain nutrients, and guess what? Fungi and bacteria can harvest those nutrients. They then make these available to the plant in a process that the plant actually controls. This means that plants get access to the type of nutrients they need precisely when they need them. That's how you maximize yields and optimize profits. For the environment, there is a whole host of benefits of having a balanced soil food web. Humanity is facing a number of existential threats. Let's take a look at how some of these are related to the soil. The most obvious one is soil erosion. The United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization has estimated that we only have around 60 years left before all the world's topsoil is depleted. Other estimates are as low as 30 years. The soil food web prevents soil erosion by both wind and water by building structure. Please watch the animation on soil structure for more information. Another existential threat we are facing is ecosystem collapse. The UN has recently stated that insect populations have been decimated by around 25% each decade for the last 30 years. That means that there are 57% less insects today than there were in 1989. Bird populations have declined by 1/3 in the last 15 years in parts of Europe. So how does the soil food web help? Well, the UN has identified the use of pesticides as a major cause in the decline of insect populations. Please watch the animation on pests and diseases to find out how nature's operating system protects plants against attack, eliminating the need for pesticides. Another threat to life on Earth is climate change. Fortunately, the soil is capable of holding tremendous amounts of carbon in the bodies of microorganisms, and some mega-organisms too. The biggest living organism in the world is not a whale, it's a fungus found in Oregon that is the size of 1,665 football fields. It is between 2,000 and 8,000 years old, and it is made mostly of carbon. By restoring the soil food web, we could put a stop to climate change. Please watch the animation on soil carbon sequestration for more details. At the Soil Food Web School, we train people like you to help farmers transition away from using chemicals to farming in harmony with nature by restoring the soil food web. For more information about the numerous benefits of the soil food web and how you can get involved, visit soilfoodweb.com.